Cornyn.
Thank you, Chairman Murkowski, Ranking Member Cantwell, colleagues. Thank you for holding this hearing to consider the nomination of my friend, Governor Rick Perry, to be Secretary of the Department of Energy and to allow me the opportunity of introducing him. I want to just introduce his wife, Anita, who is here today. He has his extended family, including some of his adopted family, here with him today, and I'll let him introduce the rest of them. But I got to know Sandy and I, my wife, and I got to know Rick and Anita when we both ran for statewide office in 1990. It's been a few years now. Rick had already served in the Air Force, and he'd served in the state legislature before being elected as Agriculture Commissioner in Texas. I got elected to the Texas Supreme Court that same year. And of course, later in December of 2000, Rick assumed the office of governor of the state of Texas, becoming, as the chair, Chairman Murkowski noted, the longest serving governor in our state. Serving in public office alongside of someone that long gives you a chance to assess their character and their abilities. I'm here to say that I know Governor Perry to be a tremendous leader of the highest caliber and a dedicated public servant who is committed to working on behalf of the people of Texas and now on behalf of the nation. Rick Perry is not a status quo kind of guy. He's a leader. He's an innovator. Texans are by nature practical people looking for solutions to problems. And Rick has led in that spirit, and I believe the results in our state speak for themselves. We've been blessed by the leadership of Governor Perry. During his tenure, the state thrived, even as much of the rest of the country languished. Texas not only added almost 2 million jobs during his time in office, but was responsible for the lion's share of all job growth across the nation from 2007 to 2014. It's really a remarkable statistic. While he was governor, Texas also became the top exporting state in the country, a title we've held for more than 14 years in a row now. The crime rate dropped, and thousands of miles of highway lanes were added to our roadways. In other words, under Governor Perry's watch, Texas flourished, and he helped give Texans everywhere even more to brag about. But the real measure of a leader is tested in times of hardship and trial. Though massive wildfires in places like Bastrop, to major hurricanes along our Gulf Coast, to the tragic explosion in West Texas fertilizer plant a few years ago, every time Governor Perry demonstrated that he was able to rise to the occasion, make tough decisions, and meet the challenge placed in front of him. And on top of all of these accomplishments, Rick Perry also has a proven track record of success when it comes to the Texas energy landscape, not an insignificant part of our economy. Many associate Texas with the oil and gas industry, and that would be fair. But during Rick's time in Austin, he championed an all-of-the-above energy strategy. Really, an all-of-the-above energy strategy. It wasn't just rhetoric. It revolutionized production in our state and led to more efficient energy use, more jobs, and more innovation. So today, Texas not only leads the nation in oil and gas production, but produces more wind energy than any other state in the country, more than all but five countries in all. Under his leadership, solar energy has continued to grow, and Texas is poised to become a national leader in solar power as well. And thanks to his common sense approach to governing, the shale revolution arrived in Texas in a big way, creating thousands of jobs and making energy even more affordable for Texas families. So Rick doesn't fall into the either-or trap that so many seem to have fallen into, a zero-sum game when we talk about energy. He found a way to spur innovation and investment in new technologies without stifling existing technologies and while reducing our state's carbon footprint as well. In other words, the guiding principles of Governor Perry's tenure are smart regulation, encouraging innovation, and creating a climate that grows every aspect of energy production and has continued to serve our state well. So I have absolutely no doubt that Rick Perry will put forward an America First energy policy at the department. and will help spawn the next great era of American energy. He has a track record, he has the know-how, and a real desire to export more American energy to enhance security of our friends and allies abroad. Put another way, Rick Perry is simply the right man for the job, and it's an honor for me to support his nomination to be the third Texan to head the Department of Energy. Thank you, Madam Chairman.